But you're aware that in many states, I mean, in many state governments, there's what they call the security vote, which is separate from whatever it is they spend on security.
I cannot speak for other governments, okay? But I can speak authoritatively for the Kaduna State government. This is what we do. This is my response. And as I said, even the state governments that are least transparent in Nigeria have a detailed budget running into tens of pages with hundreds of line items. The National Assembly budget, which is bigger than most states' budget, is one line, 115 billion naira. Break it down at least to the level of the budgets of state governments before you ask state government to break their own further. That is all. But we, as Kaduna State Government, offered to say, okay, you've challenged me. This is Kaduna State Government. I can speak for Kaduna State Government. I can defend it. And I want to say very clearly and authoritatively, there is no other security vote in the Kaduna State Government other than what we published.
But what they seem to be suggesting when the speaker spoke was that, you know, he who comes to equity must come with clean hands. Maybe he felt that you were not in the place to be telling them to be transparent.
Well, then he can tell me if my hands are not clean. I challenge anyone in Nigeria, anyone, to question my integrity, to bring out any details of what I've ever done wrong. I've been in public life for a long time. I am perhaps the most investigated public officer in Nigeria. Senate committees, House committees, every law enforcement agency under Umar Yar'Adua and Jonathan have investigated me and found nothing. I even have something to say, Mokwe. Yesterday, I won a case against the federal government, which I instituted in 2008 or 2009, when a committee of the Senate lied falsely that 32 billion naira was missing. No, they didn't say missing. They said not accounted for from the process of sale of government houses. I went to court, I submitted audits, I submitted audited accounts and details. And after 8 years, yesterday, the Federal High Court ruled and said not a penny was missing. I am an open book. Anyone that wants to investigate me is free to try. But that does not, even if my hands are not clean, that does not mean the National Assembly's budget should not be broken down. It is a national institution, and they are accountable to Nigerians. They cannot use the standards of one man or one state government to hide their own budget and do whatever they want. That's all we're asking for.
Are you satisfied now that they say, well, this year's budget will be open?
They have been saying that forever. Let us see it. Let's see how open it is. Let them know. We'll ask more questions if it is not open enough.
But going by the intensity of the conversation that has been going on, I mean, in terms of the words that have been used, people suggest that this is not just about the budget. Maybe this is covering up something else. This stems from something else. You were not satisfied and you were not happy with the emergence of the leadership of the National Assembly. Does this have anything to do with your words to the National Assembly?
No. Actually, if you go through my social media platforms, I've been asking for the breakdown of the National Assembly budget since 2010, when it became a single line item under Yar'Adua. Up to the time I was federal minister, the budget of the National Assembly has always been detailed out. Okay? And the last budget we did as Federal Executive Council under Obasanjo, I remember the budget of the National Assembly was about 50-something billion naira. It moved to 150 billion under Yar'Adua without explanation and without a breakdown. And since then, out of government, in opposition, I have been making calls for that 150 billion to be broken down and justified. And it is a legitimate demand on the part of a citizen of Nigeria. I have that right, not even as a state governor, but as an ordinary citizen to demand for that. I don't see what is the issue about who is the leader of the National Assembly or not. It does not matter. Really.
But what is your relationship with the leadership of the National Assembly?
I have no relationship with them. Because I'm a state governor. My only relationship officially is with the State House of Assembly.
Not even because you're of the same party?
No, we're in the same party. We are friends. Dogara is my kid brother. He calls me Babanyaya, which means elder brother. We respect each other. And yeah, we have personal relationships. But we don't have an official relationship. I have no relationship with the National Assembly.
And the Senate?
Because the same.
Bukola in the initial statement, you were very particular about the Senate. You said particularly the Senate when you were talking about transparency. Does this have anything to do with your relationship?
The president of the Senate is the chairman of the National Assembly. He has to lead on this. Speaker Dogara is second in command. It is up to the chairman of the National Assembly, the Senate president, Dr. Bukola Saraki, to make that decision. And indeed, the last time I heard about opening up the budget of the National Assembly was at a social media event in Lagos, where his own representative at that event promised that the National Assembly budget would be published. This was in March. And there has been nothing. I don't know how long it takes to publish the budget of the National Assembly. It's like 2 minutes. You can publish it online and tell us, and everyone will know. It has nothing. Look, this is not personal. I don't have any problem with Dogara, as I said. I don't have any problem with Bukola Saraki. We worked in Obasanjo's government together. We had our differences when they were in the Eradua government, but we move on. We're in the same party. We worked together in the Buhari campaign. We worked very well together. He is free to contest for presidency of the Senate. And it is his right. And, you know, he is the president of the Senate. I recognize that. But this call has nothing to do with any of that. When people try to muddy the waters and say, oh, you are doing this because of this, it's nonsense. Look at it objectively. It is only in Nigeria that you catch a thief and he say, oh, you are catching me because I'm a Yoruba man or Igbo man or Hausa man. You are a thief. Explain it.
Well, we'll take a moment now. When we return, we will turn our attention to that all-important leaked 30-page memo. Just stay with us.